The NRA is becoming less and less popular because of their extreme stance. They have the extreme stance because they represent gun manufacturers and they want to sell as many guns and bullets and magazines as they possibly can, no matter what. But American people are kind of onto it. So first of all, stricter gun laws, are they in favor of it? Yes. Now, 53 to 40, it has definitely swung in gun control's direction, and Americans are saying, let's get some stricter gun laws, no question about it.
I'm still surprised by that number. That still seems... I'm not a polling expert. I don't have my finger on the pulse of America, unlike every politician. but I would imagine that number is higher.
Yeah, and of course, it always depends on how you ask the poll question. But remember, for a long time, the gut reaction of Americans was, yeah, Second Amendment, gun rights, absolutely.
Yeah, well, so, first of all, I'm sure if you asked, we want to ban assault rifles and high capacity magazines, that number's going to be higher.
Oh, I have seen polls where that specific number is higher, and it gets people more connected, like, oh, that's assault
that's
weapons? I want to ban that.
Yeah, we want to gun show loophole, this, these four things. These are the four things we want to do.
Right.
It's going to be like Obamacare, like the Affordable Care Act. You know, again, I hate it. Here are the eight things in it. Oh, those are good.
Yeah, well, those I love a lot. Yeah, right? You're getting rid of the pre-existing condition thing?
I keep my kid on the plan. That's fantastic.
Great. Right. Okay. So now, the NRA had also been popular, and now for the first time it has flipped. What's interesting is that even after the Newtown shooting, it was the NRA polled positively 48 to 41. But after their press conference, they actually, for the first time, slipped into negative territory. 42% of voters saying they view the NRA positively and 45% unfavorably. It was their reaction to Newtown that did them in. So because the whole idea of arming everybody at the schools, people were like, whoa, these guys aren't reasonable. They went from, hey, like they're waiting to see what they're going to say, and are they going to be reasonable and say, hey, maybe we should do a little bit of gun control? No, and they went in the opposite direction.
It's not just
people were like, oh, I'm done with them.
It's not just the, it wasn't just what they said. It was the manner in which they said it, too.
I mean, callous.
The sort of the disregard. And in some of those statements that John read earlier, they still don't get it. As soon as I start reading those things that the NRA has said, I instantly think, God, these guys, their PR is surprisingly horrible. Mm-hmm. For a group with this much money, this well-funded, allegedly, I'm still stunned by it, this politically powerful. Mm-hmm. They are totally tone-deaf.
I think there's two reasons for that. They live in their own bubble, and in their own bubble, everybody agrees that everybody should have an RPG.
Could they be tone deaf from the sound of guns going off their entire
That's
life?
That's not a bad point either. And another thing is they get paid to be extreme, so there is no, they're at an 11, and they can't turn it down. They have no way of turning the down, because they get paid to go more and more, sell more guns, sell more bullets. Now, when you ask specifically about their proposal that they proposed in the press conference about arming teachers, for example, 27% say, yeah, let's arm teachers. 64% say, hell no.
There's 27% who say we should.
I know, it's insane. That's 27% of the country. You're never going to reach on this issue.